Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Shubham and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. In this episode, we will learn about ESP32-C3, its important features and its applications. Espressif has undisputedly been a leader in the IoT market with its chips such as the ESP8266 and the ESP32. However, Espressif has now decided to focus on making chips with specific needs rather than going for the one-size-fits-all model. Espressif just introduced a new chip based on the RISC-V architecture called the ESP32-C3 for simple and secure connectivity applications in the late half of 2020. The new ESP32-C3 has a single 160 MHz RISC-V based core that outperforms the ESP8266. The ESP32-C3 sports a 400 kilobytes SRAM which manages to keep it all running while burning less power. It has an integrated 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi and Bluetooth Low Energy 5.0 for long-range support. It has 22 programmable GPIO pins with support for ADC, SPI, UART, I2C, I2S, RMT, TWAI and PWM. ESP32-C3 attempts to solve connected devices' most common needs, namely security, low energy Bluetooth availability and sufficient memory. It is said that security is the biggest issue stunting the growth of the IoT market. The ESP32-C3 has special features that provide sufficient protection from security threats. 1. Secure boot. ESP32-C3 implements the standard RSA 3072 based authentication scheme to only run trusted applications on the platform. This feature prevents from executing a malicious application programmed in the flash. 2. Flash encryption. ESP32-C3 uses the AES-128XTS based flash encryption scheme to keep the application and the configuration data encrypted in the flash. This provides protection for sensitive data stored in the flash and protects from runtime firmware changes that constitute time of check, time of use attacks. 3. Digital signature and HMAC peripheral. The digital signature peripheral housed in the ESP32-C3 generates digital signatures using a private key protected from the firmware access. Similarly, the HMAC peripheral generates a cryptographic digest with a secret that is protected from firmware access. These features protect the identity of the device even in case of software vulnerability exploits. 4. World Controller. ESP32-C3 has a new peripheral called the World Controller. This provides two execution environments fully isolated from each other. As Espressif focuses on making this chip for simple connected devices, the Bluetooth 5.0 for long-range support is one of the most important features of this chip. Typically, connected devices use Wi-Fi connectivity to connect to cloud services. However, Wi-Fi-only devices possess difficulty in network configuration and also fail to provide reliable configuration feedback to the provider. The availability of Bluetooth provides easy discovery and control in the local environment. The ESP32-C3 has added support for the Bluetooth Low Energy 5.0, which has an improved range of almost 100 meters. It also supports the Bluetooth Low Energy Mesh protocol, which helps to control and communicate with other Bluetooth Low Energy 5.0 sensor devices in a local network. The ESP32-C3 is designed to handle one or at times two TLS connections with Bluetooth active all the time and also a reasonable application in the headroom. This is possible because of its 400 kilobyte SRAM. Further, it also has a partitioning for the instruction and data memory. This effectively maximizes usable memory. As always, Espressif supports the ESP32-C3 with matured software support through ESP-IDF, making it easy to connect it to many devices and cloud agents. Espressif has released two models for the ESP32-C3, the ESP32-C3 Mini 1 module, which comes with a small form factor of 13x16.6mm and supports a maximum operating temperature of 105 degrees Celsius. For ease of use and migration, Espressif has also launched the ESP32-C3 Vroom 1 module, pin-to-pin compatible with ESP Vroom 02D, and ESP-ROM02 modules. The ESP32-C3 may not be as newbie-friendly as other chips, but is a head start in building solutions focused on particular use cases. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.